That's my only one emotional cousin. Okay. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I know a lot of you are tired already, but we are not wicked enough to let you go. I think we have been benevolent and generous to allow you to. Really?
Yes, sir.
Where you? We trust God to help us today again. A lot has been going on. We've been learning so much. I don't know about you, but I have been learning. If you have not been learning, sincerely speaking, you are wrong. And nobody can be able to help you. Even God himself cannot help you. The system upon which God helped men is a system of education. The system upon which the devil destroyed men is a system of education. And it is unfortunate that you can never be upon a neutral ground upon the face of the earth. You cannot wake up and decide that you will not do God. You will not do the devil. It's not given to you. You did not create yourself. And even if you create yourself, this world is a world full of all kinds of spirits. And as long as you are not influenced by a divine spirit somehow, spirits that are not divine will find expression in your life. And that is the reason why you need to be guided, you need to be educated, you need to be put upon the right path. And whether you like it or not, the last people that actually had a sitting with Jesus Christ were actually the first apostles as of then. And even among them, to the best of his capacity as God, there was actually another that became a son of perdition. And that is to tell you that it is possible that among many of us that gathered, not everybody will become relevant, no matter how good we are, no matter how best we are as teachers, no matter how God has helped us sufficiently well. We cannot be able to ensure within our own capacity to ensure that you become something in life. It is true that you can decide that you want to become great, and your decision to become great can be helped by God if you align to his protocol. But it is possible that no matter how much interested we are in your destiny, if you don't actually put a little bit of input into it, you may amount to nothing. Not because God is wicked, but simply because you are wicked as a person. I get what I'm saying now. You must come to a point that you must realize that there is nothing wrong with God. If there is anything wrong in your life, it's because everything is wrong with you. I know you believe you are good. I agree. Where is Julius? You sang a very powerful song. Come, we will sing that song for 2 minutes. So that they don't feel as though I say they are bad. You are good, I agree. You know, when God created everything, it was good. But the system of the earth was still destroyed, although what God created was good. Something can be good and it will not be perfect. Something can be good and it will not be completed. Are you getting what I'm saying now? You must really have to understand. The Bible says it's not good for a man to be alone. But sometimes, even when a man marries, he's supposed to be good. But it can become the greatest disaster that can ever happen to a man. Creation was created and God said it was good. But when creation was launched out, it became a challenge. That upon the creation, how good creation was, it was not perfect enough. Are you getting what I'm saying now? So it is only God in himself that sustained the capacity of perfection to ensure that everything aligned to divine order. The template where which creation is run upon is not a good template. It's a perfect template. And it's very hard for mankind to align to that template if not keeping pace with God consistently. And that is why you must understand that if you are not aligned to God perpetually, there is every chance that you give air to darkness. And you may want to ask me, how then will you know a man that can give air to darkness? Me and you can. As long as you are not 100% yielded to God, you can sometimes, the devil can borrow you like Peter. And you can be with Jesus, and actually it was Satan that will be speaking through you. So it's possible that we are here, although you pray like us and everything, Satan can borrow you for a moment. And if you are not careful enough to consistently align yourself to God, you may finish shouting in tongues. We will finish teaching you all of this. Many people may listen to this thing far away. They will be blessed. But you here, they remain the way you are. I was in the room. A lady from New York, Abby. She was Germany. I think another one from New York was the one that called when I was with Paul. She was listening to the last message I preached in the mountain, intimacy with the Holy Spirit. And she said she has never had a message like that. And she decided to lock herself and continue retreating. The truth is this: you are here, and these things are educated to you, these things are taught you, but you never take them seriously. You took them upon face value after many years to come. You see, you will fail, and when you fail, it will look as though we are wicked. All of these things you see Paul is saying is because we pay attention to many things. If you don't, you will continue to see us advance, and it will look as though we scam you. The truth is that you were the one that scammed yourself. I get what I'm saying now. Just like when they told you, they promised you that you should bring 10,000, they'll give you 20,000 in 2 days. And because of the greed in you, I don't know how you believe that there was an economic system that can give you 100,000 in 1 day, just because you gave 10,000. Because of the greed in you, you gave them. And when you are scammed, you now say they are wicked. Actually, you are actually wicked too. Okay. Julius, come, let's sing that song so that they know they are good. Come. I don't understand for Julius. I don't know. He has not come the last mountain. So somehow, he's not. Me, MD, help me, help me. That is song that he just sang. I like that song. Sing it and enjoy yourself, because you'll be rebuked today. Enjoy, enjoy, enjoy. I'm devoted to your praise. Forever, you are good. You are good. You are not. You are kind. I have never seen your kind. I'm devoted to your praise. And forever you. You are good, you are kind, I have never seen your kind, I'm devoted to your praise, and forever you are good, you are kind, I have never seen your kind. And forever you are good, you are kind, you have never seen your kind, I'm devoted to your praise, and forever you are kind. I have never seen your kind. I'm devoted to your and forever you.
One more time.
You are good. You are kind. I have never seen your kind. I'm devoted to your praise. I'm forever
yes, you are love.
You are light. You make everything alright. I'm devoted to your
praise.
I'm forever
You are love.
You are life.
You make everything.
I'm devoted to your
name. To your name.
And forever you.
The hands, you're my God.
You're my God. You're my King. You're the mighty man of God.
You are good.
I have never seen your kind.
I'm devoted to your praise.
And
forever to
you are good,
you are kind. I have never seen your time. I'm devoted to your praise. I'm forever devoted to your praise.
The dynamics of spiritual power, because there is no, if I didn't lay this foundation, if I come and start talking about Kratos, this call of this thing, you won't understand. And the goal is for you to understand. I may not teach this in here, but because of this topic, I will must say it somewhere. I will teach dynamics of spiritual power again in explaining what are they. There are different dimensions of power. With this established foundation, you can actually be able to understand when I bring into you the dimensions of power. Is that okay? If I just come and tell you Kratos is good, you will call the name. And you run away from the name because you don't even know what the name is. You will still die with that name, Kratos, in your mouth, or Iskus in your mouth, because you don't even know what you're saying. Like one guy that told him, what is the mystery of Melchizedek order? We say, young man, what is Melchizedek? Doesn't even know. We say, keep quiet. Many of you have spoken too many big things, don't even know anything about it. Okay. And also, you cannot be able to understand power until you understand energy. Go and study this thing. Study what is energy. You know what I'm saying now? You need to be able to understand what is energy and how energy is converted. How energy is transformed, because energy and power are related. Okay, when we administer power, what we do is that we administer energy. When I display power here, I know an energy is displayed. How many of you have ever released power before? You felt that though something is leaving you. If you have not come, you don't know how sweet power is. Although if you do that for a very long time, you may die. Why? Because virtue will leave you too much. Sometimes after you are done like that, you go and fall down as if you want to die. There are days where you feel as though as if they have beaten you very well. The only thing that happened was that you released virtue. And that virtue you released was energy. It was the strength of the prayer you have prayed that is now transferred to heal certain kind of things. When you begin to lay hands upon like hundreds or thousands of people, virtue will be leaving you. You will literally see it leaves you. I'm very serious. Except you don't take notice of it. You will see something moving. Phew is going. Phew is going. I mean, have you felt it? Why are you looking at me like, So those are different dimensions of power that are moving. Sometimes Kratos, sometimes Iskus, sometimes whatever. But dunamis is not there, because dunamis is actually the potential one that was given unto you immediately when the Holy Ghost come. As Jesus said, ye shall receive power after the Holy Spirit come upon you. Then you shall be my witness. Because the only way you can truly witness for the kingdom of God is when power is supplied unto you. When Jesus made that proclamation, what he actually intended to do was to actually be able to give them a level of potential power. That's why I told you that by the time you study this energy very well, you understand actually that there is kinetic energy and there's what? Potential energy. And we talk about kinetic energy as energy that is what? Emotion. Potential energy is energy that is at the state of rest. Dunamis, when you receive dunamis, as Jesus speaking in the book of Acts, where they were trying to refer to what he said to them, that they will receive power after the Holy Ghost come upon them. He was trying to let them understand they will receive what? Potential energy. But they also receive what? Dunamis. When the Holy Spirit come upon them, then they will be witness. But do you know that they can never go and become witness with dunamis? It's impossible for them to witness with dunamis. It's impossible for them to witness with what? Potential energy. You need to translate it to what? Kinetic energy. That's why you must have to understand the system of conversion energy. Your electricity, what? Paul went and bought one iron. We saw the iron, we thought it was very big. So we felt because it's big, it can iron clothes very well. That iron is the one of the most laziest iron I've ever seen. But I felt like ironing my pot belly with it. It doesn't get hot. But there is an iron that Abby has. That iron is very slim, like me. But that iron can burn your clothes if you own it for just 2 minutes. Why? Because there is kinetic energy. That one may have energy, but it's what? Potential energy. So energy has to be converted to diverse form for it to profit you. I get what I'm saying now. When you unplug an iron from the electric switch, do you know that you can put it in your stomach? No wahala. But don't plug it and leave the iron in your stomach for 2 minutes. You understand the difference between power and power. You know the difference between what I call potential energy and what? The other time that when the iron was there, there is power inside. There is energy inside. Just that the energy is not what? Kinetic yet. When you put electricity, when you plug it, it will not begin to be converted. It's the same way that you have what we call potential energy. Is that okay? When you begin to pray in the Holy Spirit is a converting factor. When you begin to pray in the Holy Spirit, He plunges you into another realm that begins to convert the power into diverse dimensions as you can need it, so that it can function. I get what I'm saying now. That is why you can go for a meeting when you begin to pray in tongues. There are certain kind of tongues you pray, certain kind of impactation happen. Do you realize that? If I want to deliver somebody, I can. You tell me, say you don't. I used to think before that when you are casting out devils, you don't speak in tongues. When I agree, I discovered there's a tongue you use to cast out devils. There's a tongue that demons understand. I get what I'm saying now. It is true. You must understand that the tongues that you see has different converting factors. You are the only one that think that tongues are just tongues. If you have totally prayed very well, there are days that the tongue switch. Why it's switching is because you need a level kind of power to combat certain what is going on at the moment. That's why when you begin to pray in tongues, certain time you begin to, maybe you just saw a vision of your village and you saw a port, then your tongues change. The reason why your tongues change was because you need to switch power from dunamis maybe to iskus. So immediately when you shift it to iskus, that will be required for you for that next 5 minutes to do that kind of prayer. After that was done, suddenly you now see a vision of the need for you to gain admission, then you switch it again to exousia. Suddenly your tongues now switch. So the switching of the tongues is changing realms into a different dimension of power. I don't have the time to bring you to understand what iskus means, what exousia means, what kratos means. I get what I'm saying, because if I want to do that, it's going to take a lot of time. And I have to take you to scripture to let you understand that these are the diverse dimensions of power as seen in scripture. Maybe you just write them and you go and study them. Is that okay? Anytime you hear the word power in scripture, it doesn't mean generic. There are a lot of time when you hear power put in view. In fact, there are certain scriptures that you see they put different, they put power. All of them are different. Just like the word love in Bible is similarly different thing. Love not the world, none of the things of the world. If anybody love the world, love Father's name, they are not the same thing. It means that the Bible is confused, they are the same thing. Just that, of course, the people that actually translate these things actually cannot have articulate word to be able to put in understanding. So they use the Greek or the Hebrew rendition to ensure that this is connected. But until you use lexicon, you may not be able to understand the difference. I get what I'm saying now. So, for instance, when you want to see the word dunamis, go and read the context of this scripture. You understand where power is applicable in keeping to dunamis. Where were they referring to? Read the book of Acts chapter 1. Anytime you see power in Acts chapter 1, most times it's dunamis. Read the book of Matthew 6, 13. Matthew 22, verse 29. Anytime, when you look at the context there, he was talking about a power that was actually inherent in them. Power that is actually in a potential state. Okay. Then, there is also another dynamics of power named Kratos. When you read the book of Ephesians 6:10, Kratos was the power that was referred to there. And the context there was because there was a need for Kratos there. When you read the book of Ephesians 1:19, you discover there was both Kratos and there was both dunamis. The first one, the first power that was called there was Kratos. The second power there was what? Dunamis. When you read the book of 2 Thessalonians 1:9, the word power there is actually the word iskus. And the reason why it is iskus was because the required kind of energy converted power there that will be required for that thing to be pushed through is iskus. You know that if I want you to carry this stone, I cannot just say go and apply power. I know that for you to carry this stone, another kind of power must be applied. You don't understand what I'm saying. It's no longer, we call it power of choice. It's a lie. You can't use exousia. You can't use your power of choice. There has to be some level of kratos. There must be some level of excitement in the power to come to a level where you can be able to carry it. When you see Samson display the thing he displayed, it was not the power of choice. It's a lie. That was why when they cut the hair, when he tried to operate his choice, it didn't work again. Why? Because he doesn't know that was making him do what he was doing was a power that was supplied by a mechanism of conversion. Okay. There is also another power called exousia. And when you read the book of Luke, chapter 10, verse 19, exousia is what was applicable. But also, the first one was exousia. The second one is actually dunamis. When you read the book of Matthew 9:6, exousia was what was applicable. There's another dimension of power I know the people have not been told. There's another one called didomai. There are many dimensions of power in keeping to the Greek rendition. Of course, the Hebrew in the Old Testament, we cannot define it because there are too many. But in Hebrew, of course, these are the few that we are stated, but there's also didomai. Didomai was referred a lot of time in the book of Revelation. If you read the book of Revelation 13, verse 14 and 15, and Revelation 16, verse 18, you actually see the operation of power in keeping to the domain. If you have Greek lexicon, if you check, you discover that the context where we've been talking is different. Also, the operation is actually different. Okay, the other dimension of power that was not too converse and common to people is a dimension called Ike. There's another dimension of power called Ike. This dynamics of power referred to as Ike is what principality use. Principality, their power is in what we call Ike. Mind you, the word authority is also the word exousia. Authority in scriptures most times is referred to as exousia, because when God gives you authority, you can function in that choice of power given unto you. It's also exousia. So there are a lot of times in scripture when you see the word authority, it actually means power, but the power given unto you by God to be able to function. I get what I'm saying now. Then the word Ake is the power that principality use. If you read the book of Luke 20:20, it speak about Ake and also exousia, because Ake speak about a power that originated, a power that has been from the very beginning. I get what I'm saying now. It's like an original power that is like in the beginning. There's no time. Then the last dynamics of spiritual power that's available is what we call energy. Energy is actually seen in the book of Hebrews 4:12. It speaks like kinetic power. It speaks like kinetic power that is at function to ensure that a thing is done. I get what I'm saying now. So anytime you begin to pray in tongues and you discover that your tongues are switching and changing, a lot of time is transition, but that transition may not necessarily be a promotion in the spirit. It may just be that you are switching in realm of power to be able to combat a certain level of authority. A lot of time you can begin to pray and your tongues will switch, then you break through a stronghold, then wisdom and revelation is broken unto you. It was a required kind of power for you to break through whatever. Have you ever prayed before and you don't feel that thing was answered? Have you felt that? What happened that you actually ascend to a level of power, then because of the supply of that power, you knew that if that power was in view, this thing is done. And it will amaze you that it is done. A lot of time when we combat, when we see people that are sick and whatsoever, and when we say in the name of Jesus this, what we do is that we try to come with a level of power that has the ability to be able to combat, to rescue together with another power, because there is already a power in view. I get what I'm saying now. The Bible speaking in the book of Acts chapter 10:30, it says how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and with what? Power. Who went about doing good and healing others. You know, the power that God had to put into to ensure that Jesus Christ does the things he does was simply because powers are actually in view upon the face of the earth. There are already powers in view upon the face of the earth. And these powers are after getting dominance over the lives of people. So, if you must also be able to salvage people from the bondage of those powers, you have to also be given another kind of power. But in that kind of power that you're given is actually potential in its ability to be able to be excelled to the level to which you can combat it. That is why if you pray more, you will do more in keeping the power. The realm of prayer is the realm of power. A man that does not pray, he may be very powerful, but he'll be powerful in the realm of glory. I end with this. I believe that there are about three dimensions in God. You can choose one, but I've realized that I can decide to choose both. There is the realm of power. The realm of power comes by prayer. Check all through. Everybody that pray, he doesn't have to have a knowledge. He'll have power. And that power can do wondrous things beyond his imagination. It's a realm in God. But there's also the realm of knowledge. That realm of knowledge leads you to what I call the realm of wisdom. There are people that may not be able to pray, but when you come close to them, they use the wisdom to get the same result that the man of prayer gets. Do you know you take drugs? Drugs did not come by prayer. Drugs come by wisdom. Some people lock themselves inside. No, you're not praying. They engage a realm of knowledge and they're able to create certain things. And that thing has power because knowledge itself is what? When you apply a kind of knowledge, it will grant unto you power. The reason why occultic people fly at night may not be because they receive an impactation. Many of them, there was a knowledge they have. I told Akwanza, he told me he asked a lady and she educated him a little bit. Learn to ask occultic people, how do you fly at night? When you meet those small children, before you cast out the spirit in them, ask them. They don't lie that time because they know you can do the thing. Ask them, they will tell you. They will tell you how they change to card, how they change to this. There's a level of knowledge that they have that informs them to that. I'm doing what I'm doing because of a kind of knowledge. So there is a realm of wisdom that comes by knowledge. But there's another realm, we call it the realm of glory. The realm of glory comes by what I call intimacy. It comes by the power of the presence. There are people that may not be able to shout in tongues. You never even see them pray in tongues. You know, Kajin Kuma never pray in tongues. I have plenty of videos I will give you. He never hears. I watch very well to see. I don't do small like this. He will never do. But that woman is a woman of intimacy. She carries a certain level of glory. There is a spirit that possesses her. When that woman come here, oh my God, even this rock will shift location. Why? She's just a woman of the presence. So there is that dimension of God that can come upon a man just because he dwell in the secret place, just because he remain in a presence. He may not even know anything. He may not have too many revelations. But I'm telling you, because of the power of just remain in the presence, communion, fellowshiping with the spirit will overshadow him. And when the man moves, the spirit go ahead of him. I get what I'm saying now. But you can decide to combine all of these realms of operation. You can decide to pray. You can decide to know. You can also decide to dwell with the Spirit of God. And you can combine the realm of glory. You can combine the realm of power. You can also combine the realm of wisdom. I get to, can we pray? 1 minute now. And ask the Lord and say, Father, these dynamics of spiritual power that are available. Father, as we begin to pray, whatsoever required kind of power that I need in keeping to the challenge in my family, whether I need an admission, whether I need a healing, whether I need anything to change in my family, let there be a converting factor to ensure that this is answered in the name of Jesus. Shibabalina kuza, balia rabaska vilatani, mabalate na kuza brate kebele tulaka baska balate, mababaladule kebele tulaka skabaria la kabaskata, rababalane kobai, baria la babus, baradam baska brata babula teska. Raba la bebena bashka brata babula tababuska beleteska. Raba balateska baratu leke de besko brato ko balakeda. Baba bala babul, baba da babula bebenda bashka brata babula tua.
Activate power in me.
Baba bala babunda bashka brata babula tua. Manda baska bala tela, bando babala tu leke skebele dia. Raba la tabakwa na babala tu leke babada babashka bala dia. Raba bala bamba dabash kablada babala tuleba baska tabala tia. Mambas kabala teda babuas kalababoana. Zaba bala de kababunda bash kablada babala tia. Bale beska bele teska. Raba bala babunda bash kababulieta. Many of you have received the Holy Spirit, but you have not translated it onto power. Ask the Lord and say, Father, let the dunamis begin to be converted. Let the power begin to be converted. Let the potential power, the potential energy begin to be converted. Because there are problems that need to be solved in our families. There are problems that need to be solved in our life. We need the powers to be converted. We need them. We need them to be converted. Babylina, Babylina. Babylina, the Cobas. You need the right kind of tongues. You need the right kind of tongues at a season, at a time. You need it. That's why sometimes you can be traveling. An accident is about to happen, you blast in one kind of tongues like that. It's a level of conversion, my friends. It's a level of conversion. Babelate akwa. Mabelate kobalashka. Mabelabena shkabala dilatade. Maba laba mena bash kabda da babula tani ya. Babella tesco balatina ya. Mala babana badi ala babuska. Julius. Babella tinai. Can we sing that song? Baba la da babula. Baba la da shkabda da babula. We are done. And we see you are good again, and we are done. Shabana and Kobala Babella Day, Babella Day, Babella Day. Rababella Nabakwash Kabala Dia. Baba Lata is God.
Make everything alright. I'm devoted to your praise. Forever,
you are good.
You are good.
You are not.
You are kind.
I
have never seen your kind. I'm devoted to your praise. And forever you are. You are.
are good, you are kind. I have never seen your kind. I'm devoted to your praise, and forever you are good. You are kind. I have never seen your kind. Devoted to your praise, and forever you are good. You are kind. You have never seen your kind. I'm devoted to your praise, and forever you are good. You are kind. I have never seen your
name.
I'm devoted to your
name,
and forever you.
One more time, sing.
You are good, you are kind. I have never seen your kind. I'm devoted to your
name.
I'm forever
you. Yes, you are love.
You are life. You make everything alright. I'm devoted to your
name,
and forever
you. Lord, you are love.
You are love.
You are life.
You are life.
You make everything.
You make everything
perfect.
I'm devoted to your
name, to your name,
and forever you.
You're my God,
you're my God, you're my King, you're the mighty man of God. I'm devoted to your King, I'm forever
yours. Yes, you're my God,
you're my God, you're my King, you're the mighty man of God. I'm forever
you
are good. You are kind.
You are kind.
I have never seen your kind. I'm devoted to your praise. I'm forever you are. You are good, you are kind. I have never seen your
kind.
I'm devoted to your praise, and forever you are. I'm devoted to your praise. I think question, right?
Yeah.